Welcome back, everyone. This is Corey, aka Lord Epion from Hit Points Gaming, about to run through my year 6 of Kingdom Death Monster. I've been contemplating on if I should switch over and fight the antelope. I know it's a new fight, and I do want to show everyone how that works, but honestly, there's nothing that I desperately need from the antelope right now. I'm trying to shoot to gain another set of armor, so I'm trying to go for just really some extra resources and innovations right now, and I feel pretty comfortable fighting the white lion until I can maybe move up to a level 2 white lion. So I'm going to do this for another, probably about a year or two, seeing how things go. But let's see who I'm bringing out for this year's fight. First up is going to be Leia. She's going to be replacing Ventress and going to be my archer this year. She does come with the secret fighting art of Red Fist, so she gives everyone a plus 1 strength token when she goes out, which is great. I think she got max survival last year for having babies, so she goes out with 3 survival. Next is going to be Padme. She's replacing Ahsoka, who, again, last year, her and Ventress got into a fight and killed each other, really. So she's going to be stepping in wearing the full White Lion set, having 1 survival. She still has a broken jaw, so she won't be able to encourage or consume anything. Next is going to be Obi-Wan. He's coming back out because he is 1 away from gaining proficiency with the sword, so I think that's going to be hopefully at the end of this fight. And he now has the full Rawhide set this year because I got the Rawhide boots in a race last year. You get plus 1 to all hit locations, and when you perform a survival action, roll a d10 on a result of 6 or more, gain a survival back. So I have 50% chance of gaining my survival back. I will guarantee that I will completely miss this roll. It's just how it is. This is the number 1 roll that I always miss. And finally, it's going to be Jabba. He's going out with the counterweight axe again. He's going to be holding the cat eye circlet. Hopefully start getting him proficiency with the axe. I did not, now this might be foolish, I did not repurchase him a skull helm. I asked him, he said he's fine with it because his courage is so high. Trying to save that resource, I don't know if it's going to be a mistake or not. We will find out. One other thing I wanted to point out is Obi-Wan is going out with that butcher's cleaver that I got last year. So he's going to try and get 1 wound with that bone blade to gain that proficiency, and then he'll switch over to butcher cleaver just as long as he is insane, because he has to be insane in order to activate this gear. So I'm going to set up for the hunt phase. And hopefully, I'm looking to slaughter some white lion cubs. I need some extra resources. That's another reason why I'm fighting this white lion. My survivors depart. So I've got the, I already accounted for this, but all my survivors, because of the lantern oven, gained the plus 1 survival. And last year, I also went to the shrine and worshipped it, and I got plus 1 insanity for all these survivors that are going out, which I already took account of, I just didn't mention it earlier. So we will start things off with Jabba here. I always like him to take point. The first card, we have White Lion Cub. Alright, so the survivors sign a White Lion Cub. They may choose to slay the cub. If they do, each survivor gains 1 random basic resource, and then roll on the table below. So this is exactly why I want to fight the lion. So let me shuffle these up. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4. Awesome. Separate these out. And then I roll on this table. 6. The father lion shows up. Begin the showdown immediately. Alright. Well, that was a very quick showdown, but that's really what I want. I want those resources. Another reason why I want to fight the lion, because I know he has a lot of events that give like plus 1 courage, I think plus 1 understanding, so it's a good way to beef your guy up. The antelope, I believe, I think it's just a little bit harder in that hunt phase, so as long as I luck out with this white lion cub, it's totally worth it. So I will set up the white lion phase. Let me just pull the terrain. Got a bug patch, and some more grass. Alright, so I got the 4 tall grasses set out. I also have the bug patch right here that has to be next to the monster. Since I did get that skull resource off that lion cub, whenever you gain a skull, I gave my one insanity to Obi-Wan. So hopefully he'll be able to stay insane to use the butcher's cleaver. And as always, the monster does go first. So let's take a look here. The first move is Bloody Claw, an advanced move right away. Closest fire with the most bleeding tokens. Okay, there aren't any, so instead he just sniffs. And sniff is everyone becomes a target for next phase, so this is good. One move already out right away. So, next thing I'm going to do is I will have Leia. I'm going to shoot that claw head arrow to try and get that minus one evasion token right off the bat. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I am 6 away, of course, because that's where I have to be set up. So I'm going to stay where I am and fire. It's a one shot. 2, so that is a miss. So that arrow is gone. And I think she's just going to stay there. So next is going to be... let's see. Not being able to... wanted him to come out and attack here first. It would have been a little bit better for me. Let's have... Jabba... I'm going to do the cat eye circlet. So the top 3 hit locations, just so I have some heads up. The glorious mane, that fuzzy groin, which I don't want to crit on really, and the beast chest, so no trap card. So I'll do the chest on the bottom. I'm just kind of like setting up for the next fight. I don't really want to go out there. I want to be attacked in the grass, so there's really no reason for me to move forward. I will have Obi-Wan stay where he is, and I'll activate his rawhide headband so I can look at the top 2 AI cards, so I know what's coming at me. Power swat, close to start facing, so it's going to be a speed 1, so that's what I'm probably going to do. So in case I could dodge it if I really wanted to. And then chomp, so I'll put that on top. And then I've got Padme, she's just going to hang out in the bushes, getting ready to pounce. So everyone went, lion's turn again. It's going to be that power slot, close to start facing, so we're going to have him go after Obi-Wan here. So Obi-Wan, who's in the grass, monster's going to need a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to hit because of the grease and the rawhide vest. So it's a 1, so that is a miss. So then I will have, because I know that third attack is the third hit location is a charge forward, so I want to get out of his arc. So let's move to the side here with Obi-Wan, and I will attack with the bone blade. Actually, yeah, I'll stay to the side, and then attack with the bone blade. 2 attacks, so that is a 1 hit, and of course this is the glorious mane, so I can only crit on this guy. There you go. It is a critical. So it does not do a wound. If the attacker is insane, the sheer frustration grants them power. Gain plus 1 strength token. Alright. So he's got plus 2 strength token. This does not do a wound, but I do gain the Shimmering Mane resource. So let me get that out now. And I love the Shimmering Mane because it counts as 2 hide. So I cut off the hair of the lion right away. Good resources. So that is Obi-Wan. Next, I'm gonna pounce with Padme. So pounce is I spend my movement and activation, or movement and attack to move 3 spaces, and I gain plus 1 accuracy and plus 1 strength for this turn. So with all my bonuses, let's see, she gets 2 attacks with 1 guitar, 2 attacks with the other. Okay, she has plus 1 speed because of the white lion armor, so that's 5 attacks. I need 6s to hit because I'm from behind. So it's 2 hits. She's got plus 1 strength, plus 2 strength, so that's 3, 4, 5, 6 strength. Okay, so that's two hits with six strength. So I'm only going to need twos to wound this guy. Let's do the fuzzy groin first. Don't be a critical. Okay, it's a one. It's definitely not a critical. And then the chest. That one's a critical. All right. Those in the right order. So that's my first wound. And the chest. You strike the white lion's stout heart. Gain one random white lion resources. Resource. Roll a d10. If the result is a 10, the white lion dies instantly. And he doesn't. Okay. So again, another white lion resource. So that's awesome. And a white fur. Good. More hide. Alright, so that's there. I'm going to have... Alright, so she got 1 point. I'm going to mark that down now. She got the one damage with the guitar. So let me check that off for weapon proficiency for her. Because I had to start over with the guitars because poor Ahsoka... I caught her murdering people. That was bad. So next I will have Jabba. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll go here. And... I'll search the bug trap. It's a 10. So that is... Gain one random vermin resource and then archive this. That goes away. Let me get the vermin out. It's very hard to actually get these vermin. I think it's really only this bug trap and maybe the... I think the special tree can get it. So let's see what I got. Whoa, what is this? A sword beetle. Consume, archive this card, and roll 1d10. I can die instantly. It could have no effect, or I can gain +1 permanent strength from this. Okay, so Jabba gets that. I don't think he's brave enough to pop that into his mouth just yet. So let's keep that to the side. Okay. And then I've got Leia's next. She'll shoot with the bow. So she's got the +1 speed. So it's 3 attacks with the bow. I need 7s to hit. Okay. 2 hits. See what I got. In the tricep and the hand. So both of them look like they've attacked me back. So Leia is going to... I'll hit the tricep first. So strength 3, +1 token 4. So I need 4 to wound. It's a 7. That is a wound. Shot him in the tricep. Or the bicep. Oh, what was that? Let me get that correct. In the tricep. And the next one is in the hand. A 3. So that is a failure. So that means the monster is going to move at me. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to actually... I'm going to dash away. Basic action. Perform basic action. Closest. Targeting the survivor. So once he targets me, I'm going to dash away with her because she has no armor. I like her a lot because of her secret fighting art. And there's no point for me to gamble getting attacked. So I'm going to spend a... survival to dash away. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right. That's the best thing. He has movement 6, so he just kind of starts walking after me as I run away. Okay. So everyone went, and now it's the monster's turn again. Lick wounds. The monster has no wounds. Okay, they archive this. Full move the white lion directly away from all survivors. So that's going to be like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 move. Okay. Then, turn to face the closest survivor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 5, 6. So facing this way. And I take the top card from the wound stack and put it on the bottom of the AI deck without looking at it. So basically, he heals automatically one wound. And then this lick wound card goes back on top of the deck. So if I do not attack this white lion and deal a wound, he's just going to keep licking his wounds until he fully heals. It's not that cool, but at least he didn't attack me, right? So it's back to me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's have Jabba go into the side, because I want him to get that one hit off at least to gain him the axe proficiency. So let me attack from here. That's two hits. Perfect hit, but I don't have the, you know, the affinities to automatically cause a wound. So it's just two hits. In the back and the paw. So let's do the back first. So this is a strength 4. It's got plus 1 strength because of Leia coming out. So that's a 5. So you only need a 3 to wound. And it's a 2. So a failure to wounds. Monster moves forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All over the place right now. I will have Leia attack, because I want to get these wounds just to get rid of that lick wounds card. Free speed. That's 3 hits. 1, 2, 3. The femur, the soft belly, and the brow. So let's do the soft belly first. So 3, 4. I need a 4, right? 4 to wound in the belly. 6, that is a wound. Get rid of that stupid lick wounds card. Next arrow shot hits the femur for a critical. The blow lands the monster's leg. You bruise the white lion's femur, crippling its graceful movement. The white lion gains -1 movement token and gain 1 random white lion resource. Sweet. That's a wound. He gains -1 movement token. And I will gain another white lion resource, which will be some testicles. Okay. That's great. That was Leia. And then my third attack, which is in the brow. Oh my. Another critical wound. Alright. So because I crit, I don't have to do the top part, which was a wound reaction. The white line vision is impaired. The white line gains -1 accuracy token. So I shot this poor lion. Messed up its movement and its eyesight. -1 accuracy. Alright. So that was pretty good. I got rid of those lick wounds. And then I'm just going to move everyone up. So I still need Obi-Wan and Jabba to get some attacks in to gain that weapon proficiency. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. Lion's turn, who's a little upset here. Bat around. Closest threat facing? Nobody. Closest threat in field of view, which is going to be Leia here. So I'm going to, after he picks his threat, then I'm gonna dash with her again. It's working out pretty well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the monster comes after me with only 5 movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go 5. I think I get the pick. It doesn't really matter. Let's go here 5. It's the same away from her, who's about to tip over. Oh my goodness. She's really trying to hide in the grass here. Laying down. It's okay, Leia. You can stand back up. Maybe you can turn to face. Okay. Okay. I'm just dropping everything now. Okay. So it's back to my turn. I'm going to have Jabba try and get that wound in. I'm a little nervous about the trap card, but I'm going to risk it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Attack from 2 spaces away. That's 2 hits. Another perfect hit, of course. The ear and the gut. Let's do the gut first. I feel confident. 4. I think that's what I needed. Yep, I only needed a 3. So that's a wound in the gut. And the next wound in the ear, slashing. That is... It was caulked. If I ever roll and it's not perfectly flat, I just re-roll it, even though I could have wounded him right there. 5, that's still a wound. Okay, so he did a wound with an axe, so I'll check that off now for weapon proficiency. Again, just so I can, it's easier for me to remember. She's really just laying down here. I gotta re-glue her, tack her up. So that was Jabba who went first. Next, I'm gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna move her. I'm gonna move Leia. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Back here. She's just resting. She's crawling on the ground to get away. Obi, 1, 2, 3, 4. Go to the side, attack with his bone blade. That's one hit. Come on. Okay, in the elbow. If I fail here, he's gonna move forward. So I've got 2 strength from the blade, plus 2 strength token, so that's 4. And he's got plus 1 strength on him, so 5. So I only need a 3 to wound, and then I'll be set for weapon proficiencies. Yes. Got it. So I'll check that off now. But he won't gain the benefits until after the actual fight. So that is a wound. So the White Lion is already down to its discard pile, which is 3 cards. So I'll shuffle that up. I could have Padme go in. I think I'm going to. The trap comes out, the trap comes out, but she's at full health right now, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll attack from behind. She gets those 5 attacks. Hitting on 6s. Okay, one hit. In the knee. 3, I don't think does it. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Actually, a 3 does do it. That's a wound. That's why I like fighting these level 1 lines. I know you should ramp up to the next level. I hope I can plan too soon. Usually it depends on how well I can fight a level 1. So far I'm doing really good with a level 1. I actually haven't even gotten hit yet, right? So, might be fighting a level 2 soon. Level 2 goes further back on the hunt track, meaning I'm going to do more encounters, more chances for me to get another White Lion, more bonuses. But a level 2 is, you know, jump to level 2, the health doesn't really bother me, but the toughness 10. So instead of me wounding on 3s and 4s, it would be what? 5s and 6s? Really, that's not bad at all. I could do that. So, I don't know. Maybe next year, I might do it. I might go for it. It all depends on that settlement phase. So, my turn is done. Monster's up. Bat around, closest threat facing your range. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So Leia's not in range. Closest threat in field of view. So that's going to be Obi, because he's right next to her. To this lion here. This father lion protecting its cub. 2 speed, accuracy 5. 6, 7, because of all the bonuses that Obi has. And he's got minus 1 accuracy. So this poor lion hits on an 8. Both misses. I think I'm going to guarantee that that hit location trap doesn't come out. So I'll do that with Jabba first. Would hate to pull the trap card. Okay, no trap card here. So wound. Okay. Put that on the bottom. I only need to do 3 wounds to this poor thing. So let's have Obi, 1, 2, 3, go to the side here. He's going to attack with the Butcher's Cleaver. Is that new weapon. He's insane, so he can attack. 2 attacks. He needed 5s to hit, so they both fail. We'll have Ahsoka. 1, 2, 3. Ahsoka. Oh, look at me. Padme. Go from behind. Ooh. 1, 2, 3. 3 wounds, or 3 hits. So those are those 3 hit locations that I just saw. So if I wound on all 3 of these, it is game over for this lion. So the first one, right, I need 3s to wound. So I'll do, try and stab him in the ribs first. 4, that's a wound. The attacker has plus 3 or more understanding, which I don't. Benefit would have happened. Next one is going to be the beast flank. I stab him there. 8, that's a wound. Cats hate getting hit in the flank, so she gains a priority target token. And we are down to its final wound in the deltoid here. 4. That does it. Lion is defeated. Quick work. These showdowns should be pretty simple. If I keep fighting these level 1 lions, as you can see, no one got hurt once. I used, 2 survival. Everyone got their weapon proficiency. So, super easy fight. I got a bunch of resources. Let's see. Let's pull all my resources together. So I get 4 more resources from here. I'm looking for... I need that... Not... Trying to find... what is it? Let me look through here real quick and see. Oh, the golden whiskers. Because I don't have that harp. I would like to get the harp to craft. The harp allows me to... I have a chance to remove some moods in play. So that might actually be helpful if I fight a level 2 white lion to get rid of some moods. But look at all the resources that I got from this guy. Got these 4. 4 more basic resources. Broken lantern. Hide. Bone. And then let's pull everything else. I got that skull. Shimmering mane, which is 2 hide. Monster organ. Another fur. Another anything. And some testicles. So, this is a level 1 white lion. This is great. And this is why I wanted to fight the lion rather than the antelope. Because I think I'm going to be able to level up more. I really want to make a leather set, but I need ammonia first in order to do that. So, I don't think it's worth it for me to build. I could almost even build another white lion set. Here's 2 pieces here. Leather is really where it's at. If I had a leather set, I would feel more comfortable fighting a level 2 white lion. Because then I would get... I really would only get 2 more resources out of this. So I know it's boring fighting a level 1 white lion right now, but it's safe. And look at all the resources that I got from that one fight. So I'll set up for the settlement phase, and we'll see what happens from then. I'll make a decision. Maybe I'll post this. I wanted to do 2 videos today, so I might do 1 right after this. Or I'll post this, and I'll ask everyone watching, do you feel like I should do a level 2 white lion? Or, do I do this for another year or so just to pump out these resources and build up that leather set if I can? Like I said, I need ammonia. So it's up to you. Let's discuss, okay? And I will set up for the settlement phase now. Okay, settlement phase set up. I'm gonna have my 4 returning survivors gain their 1 hunt experience. So Obi-Wan now has 5, Jabba the Courageous gets 3, Padme gets 3, and Leia gets her first. So everyone got their weapon proficiency attack or wound in that phase, except for Leia, she's not old enough. But Obi-Wan unlocked the specialist ability for sword. So I'll show you what that does. So when attacking with the sword after drawing hit locations, make a wound attempt and then select a hit location to resolve with that result. So I can do this once per attack. So after I see what everything is, I can make a wound attempt and then select where I actually want to attack with that. I think I just repeated exactly what was on this card to you guys. Sorry. So that's my returning survivors. I gain 4 endeavors for them coming back. And then I will do my random settlement event. So I'll shuffle this up like normal. And then I will roll 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, no marrow hunger, skull eater, or murder event. Lights in the sky. I have never done this before. That's surprising. A spectacular light show erupts against the limitless darkness above. Swirling vivid trails seek overhead. They lift everyone's spirits. Lingering effect. The settlement collective imagination is set aflame. After rolling for any endeavor, you may add +1 or +2 to the result. Sweet. This would be a great turn to have babies, I hope. Awesome. Then, let's see, requires graves, which I don't have, requires face painting, which I don't have, and then requires inner lantern. Okay, so I do have this. This is a lingering effect here. I can do this once per settlement. A 1 through 5 silent reflection, gain a fighting art of your choice. Oh my goodness. And then a 6+, add the Skull Eater Sentinel event to the timeline next year and gain +1 understanding. Well, how awesome it would be to gain a fighting art. I do not want to risk gaining that Skull Eater. So I'm going to bypass on that. Requires Inner Lantern endeavor. But I will use this Lights in the Sky School, No One Dies. And when I do, when I try and do the augury, hopefully I can have some intimacy. Alright, so then we did update the death count, which is nobody. Update the timeline, so this is officially now year 6. And then a story event actually happens, which is Armored Strangers. So this is the Armored Strangers. These mysterious people just show up to my settlement, and I hope they're friendly. Let's see. Armored Strangers. You're visited by enigmatic figures fully enclosed in armor. They march silently through the settlement. The only noise is a metallic clang as they pause before each survivor and tap their lantern and halberds against the ground. The survivors have no choice but to helplessly await their mute deliberations. Add Kingsmen to the Nemesis encounter list. The strangers count people and take action based on the total population. So then there's a little graph here. So if it's 7 or less, I roll here. Let me show you. 7 or less, I roll on this side. 8 or more on this side. I currently have 14 population. So I roll over here. And I think if you have more population, these people are like afraid of you. Maybe not afraid of you, but they want to like, they don't want people to get stronger, I guess. So they want to harm people that have more population. So 8 or more. Well, let's see what I got. Yes. That is, let me see if I can zoom in there. That's a 10. That's a 10. I got a pretty lucky on that roll. So 8 or more, 10 plus. A halberd is left in the settlement with a survivor impaled on it as a reminder. Okay, so for -1 population, add the guidepost innovation to the settlement. So, I guess they, you know, a 10 I thought would be pretty good, but they still kill somebody. They stamp this guidepost innovation into the ground here. Let me grab that. Guidepost. The soft glow of its light fills the survivors with a sense of security. Departing survivors gain +1 survival. Great, so now I get +2 survival when I depart. And then for an endeavor, the survivor attempts to pull the weapon free from the ground. Roll a d10 and add their strength. If the result is 12 or more, gain the Lantern Halberd rare gear and lose this innovation. Archive this card. So these unnamed armored soldiers came by. They saw I had a lot of people. But maybe they wanted to give me a gift. So they picked somebody. Let's see who. See, someone I haven't used yet, really. Or someone that. Let me see. I know there's somebody that I'm using that is kind of beat up. Let me go through my list of survivors here. Sabine, I haven't used yet. Hera, she's got apathetic, which I do not like. I can't gain or use survival. That is just like a waste. You know what? Poor Hera here. She's got this mighty strike. And, man, do they want to kill her? Yeah. They impaled poor Hera right onto this guidepost, this giant halberd here. So I have -1 population. She gets killed. I am down to 13 population. Let's see. Hera, she dies. She gets impaled. I do gain a basic resource for somebody dying. I think this actually happens during the update the death count. So I'm going to grab this one resource now. It is a hide. So I will go back and double check rather than pausing right now to find out or looking through the book to see I don't know when I get this. So either I get this hide right now, which I'm not going to use anyway, or I only get it during that update death count, which is actually when I think it happens, because it just makes more sense why I have that stage. Let's see, it should actually say cannibalize right here. Whenever a survivor dies, draw one basic resource and add to the settlement storage. Well, a survivor did die right now. I'm going to take the hide now, just to make it easier. Okay. It says whenever they die, not at the when you update the death count timer. So, I've got that one hide here, but then I've got everything set on what I'm going to do. I gained that guidepost, so that's pretty cool. So let me write that down. There's no consequence innovations for gaining that guidepost. So I don't have to put anything in my in the deck there. Guidepost. Okay. Hera did die. She got impaled. Okay, I wrote that down. Okay, so I have four endeavors. And I get plus one or two on my rolls for endeavors this round. So I might actually try and pull that guidepost out of the ground. But first things first, I'm going to do my innovations here. So I'm spending monster hide, a claw, and monster organ. I know, like, a few minutes ago, I showed all those resources that I got for that level one white lion. I even had the sword beetle, and I think there was another resource that I forgot to show you guys. So there's two more to add to that whole pile. So that last fight was totally worth it. So I'll spend these three resources to go through the innovations here. I'm looking for ammonia. Or symposium to hopefully get ammonia down the road. So first one is symposium. And next, yeah. Okay guys, I am not setting these in my favor. Okay, that's why I like to shuffle these. I just called them and they came to my hand. I don't have magic, I don't know any tricks to call the Ace of Spades up. But I am going to take ammonia right now. So I don't have to worry about trying to pull it later. I can start building leather right away. So I'm going to pull ammonia. Let's see, ammonia. Departing survivors gain plus one survival. So now I'm going to have three survival when I depart. I add ammonia consequences to the deck. So let me... I'll do that. Oh, actually, I'll do that after. I don't need it right now. So that's three more endeavors I have. Awesome. So that's these resources are spent. The next thing I'm going to do, I was going to buy the scrap sword right here from the, the weapon crafter. So two attacks, now that I'm, you know, proficient with fighting with swords, I figure let me get a better one. Hits on five, three strength. On a perfect hit, the edge of the sharpness gains plus four strength for the rest of the attack, which is great. And if I set up the affinities, which I don't think I can right now, it gains deadly. Deadly means it gets a plus one to, luck roll. So I would crit on a 9 or 10 with this if I have those affinities set. So that's probably going to go to Obi-Wan. So that's by spending two bone and a scrap. So those are spent. Okay. Next thing I was going to do, even if I didn't get ammonia, I had it already planned out to get my leather worker. Because in order to get the leather worker, you have to upgrade, where is it, your skinnery. You need three hide and an organ to upgrade this. So this is my second endeavor. So I spend three hide and an organ. So that is spent for my leather working. Now, with the leather worker set, obviously you need leather to upgrade everything. In order to get leather, this is why I was hoping to get ammonia. You actually need ammonia to spend an endeavor, spend any number of hide to add equal number of leather strange resources to the settlement storage. So for every hide that I have, which I, if I get this third one right here, that would be three hide. I can archive this again too, so that would be four hide, maybe five hide right here, so I would have five leather. The shield. I have another bone in my storage. Let me check my storage real quick. The settlement phase is going to be longer than the actual fighting. So I have one hide, a broken lantern, and a skull in my storage. would like to get the leather shield right away. So that would be, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hide, 6 hide, and a skull. So 6 leather, so 1, 2, 3, ooh, oh wow, I can actually get a lot here. Let me go get all my leather. My actual leather pieces. Okay. Like I said, usually I'll have everything already crafted for you of what I want to do, but because I got the pneumonia, this adds a lot to it, so I'll just continue taping through. So, let me count all my hide up again. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm going to make this a hide, 5, and 6 for my storage. So I'm going to spend an endeavor to craft all these into 6 leathers. So that's all my hide. I have 6 leathers at the moment. So let me actually, I'll use this die right here. 6. Okay. So I have 6 of those. So then I'm going to buy a round leather shield. The shields are pretty awesome. You can actually attack with it. You get 1 attack. Okay, it sucks. It hits on an 8. It only does 1 damage. But you can actually do damage with it because you can actually gain proficiency with shields, which I've never done. But it, I don't know, might be something good. But whenever you equip a shield, you get +1 armor to all hit locations. And you can spend an action to ignore 1 hit the next time you are attacked. Last until your next act. So this is a pretty cool ability. I like just the 1 extra armor to all hit locations. So I'm going to buy one of these right away. So that is a leather, a hide, and a bone. So technically I'm going to get rid of 2 leathers here, because they both count as a hide. So I go down to 4 leather. I get rid of that 1 bone, which is that skull, in my storage, my settlement storage. So I've gained that. Let's see. For the leather mask, I need a leather and a scrap. So I will go down to 3 leather, and I'll get rid of the last scrap that I have in my settlement storage. So these are the only resources I have left, is what we see here. 3 leather, 2 organs, and this sword beetle. And that gets me the leather mask. Okay. When you depart, I gain +2 insanity, and it's 3 armor to the head. Let's see, 3 leather left. I would like to get a bone and a leather and a bone and a leather for these bone pickaxe and bone sickles. They're like different events that I can go on during my hunt phase. I can get items from there. And I needed ammonia to do this as well. But I think, as I already spent my bone, I'd rather have the shield right now. So I'll get those hopefully next turn. So 3 leather still, right? So I'm going to get, let's see what's better, bracers or boots. Let's do the bracers. So leather bracers is a leather and a hide. So that brings me down to 1 leather. So those are the bracers. We need a power gain +2 survival, 3 armor. And then for 1 leather, I can gain the leather skirt. Just 3 armor to the waist. So those are 3 leather pieces and a shield. A new sword. That was a very, very good settlement phase. I have 1 endeavor left because I spent, like I said, I spent 1 of them to actually make the leather using ammonia. So I have 1 left. So I'll use that to try and have kids. You know, I'll use the augury roll here. So let's announce, let's have Jabba again. Jabba's gonna, wait a second. I think Jabba, isn't he like a matchmaker? Jabba. Yeah, Jabba's a matchmaker, so I can spend 1 endeavor to trigger intimacy story event automatically when he comes back from a fight. So I'm going to do that. So he automatically can trigger intimacy. So let me bring out the intimacy story event to see what's coming up. I roll two dice. Okay. I don't gain the plus two on this roll. A 7 and an 8. If I had a bed, something special would have happened. But the settlement gains plus one population. The male and female survivors share a deep bond and gain plus 10 survival each. So Jabba's going to have, obviously, the child. I didn't announce which female he was going to have it with. I don't even know if it's going to matter right at the moment. Let's just say Leia again, because... Sure, she goes back up to max survival. But they're going to get it no matter what, because my max survival is 3, and if she departs, she gets max anyway. So I don't really think that matters at the moment. If she died, that would have been a problem. I guess I would have randomized who he was having a child with. I know there is a question during the last one. Oh, right. Oh, see, here's a good point. Because one of the questions that was brought up... Does the person that you nominate to do augury with, if I had augury right here, and you roll that intimacy, it brings up the intimacy event, and then it says, nominate one consenting male, one consenting female survivor to roll on the intimacy table. Well, since I nominated, let's say, Jabba on this organ grinder, and I rolled intimacy, does Jabba have to be the male that has the intimacy? Because if I rolled lower, he would have gained the survival, or he would have gained the understanding. But the intimacy says, pick two survivors. I'm playing it as Jabba has to be there. But I don't think it ever specifically says he has to be. But when Jabba comes back as a matchmaker, since he is the matchmaker, he's the one that's having intimacy automatically. But then if you go to the intimacy, again, it says nominate one consenting male and one consenting female. So if he's coming back as a matchmaker, does he have to be it? Or is he just so good at quote-unquote matchmaking, he has two people actually get together? I'm not sure, but I'm playing it as this is going to be the person that Jabba has to be the male. So, they have one child, so I go back to 14 population. For some crazy reason, they name their male child BB-8. So I'm 14 population, I'm one away from having a society, so hopefully next year. This was a long settlement phase, a lot happened, a lot of good things actually happened. I got leather, I didn't think that was gonna pan out. Now, like I said, I'm going to post this. I would like to do another year tonight. I'll check to see if I should do a level 2 white lion. I got a ton of resources this last fight, and I'm already close to having a full leather set. So if one more fight gives me enough leather, let's see. For the boots, I just need a leather and a hide, so that's 2 hides. And then the chest, a leather and bone. So 3 leathers, 3 more hide, and a bone, and I have a full leather set. Then I can absolutely do a level 2 white lion, be completely safe. I'll have the bone sickle, hopefully, another innovation, so... To be on the safe side, I fight another level 1 white lion, get a little bit stronger, and then I can fight a level 2 years from now when I have a full another leather set, and that person will be my tank, because this a level 2 white lion does more damage. Absolutely, they got a plus 1 damage counter, so they automatically do that. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Guarantee fight a level 2 white lion 2 years from now. So thanks again. This was year 6 of the settlement on Dagobah, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks a lot. Oh, sorry about this, but I was just going to start uploading this video, and as I was about to go through and edit it, I was counting through my endeavors, and I was talking to myself saying how this was probably like the easiest and most luckiest year that I've had so far. You know, the armored strangers came, all they did was kill one person, and they put that guidepost down. And I was like, oh yeah, I wanted to roll on that guidepost because I had that lights up in the sky to get the plus 2. And I realized I never actually rolled for it. You know, I did the leather working for one, I did the innovation for a second one, I had matchmaking for a third, so I was going to use my fourth to try and roll for the guidepost, to try and get, 12 or more. So let me go back and see who has the most strength. I think Chewbacca has plus 2 strength. So I'm going to have him roll. So Chewbacca, I roll a die, I add 2 because of his strength, and then I get to add plus 2 because of lights in the sky. So my roll, plus 4. So if I get an 8 or more, I can pick this guidepost up. So let me do that now and see what happens. It's a 2. So a 2, I don't get anything. So even if I tried to do intimacy with the 2, it would only have been a 4, so I would have gained a survival. So it was best to shoot for that guidepost because I would like to try and get another rare piece of gear because I think those are pretty sweet. But I guess it wasn't the luckiest settlement phase. I could have gotten one more. But yeah, just wanted to squeak that in there.